everyone. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Kenzie Harper. Today I'm going to share with you what God has done in my life over the past 4 years of high school. And let me say, it's a lot. So let me start at freshman year. During my freshman year, I was saved, but I had a mild relationship with God. I went to church on Sundays with my family and occasionally read my Bible when I felt like it. What I didn't know at the time was that I suffered from two things: hyperfixation and people-pleasing. What occupied my time was my extracurricular show choir, and what occupied my mind was always trying to be the best and to make everyone happy. I was friends with people only because I did things for them to gain their gratitude and compliments, but nothing was good enough for me. I always had to do better. I had a fear of messing up, of being called out for doing something wrong. I went on with this mindset until the end of freshman year when COVID hit and we were forced into our homes. I won't complain though, school was over in March. So we went through the summer doing nothing really but spending time with my family. It was at this time that I started to lean into God with my whole family. He showed me in this time of rest that I don't need to always be busy, I don't always have to look good or feel good, that I don't need to be perfect because He is and I can never be. When sophomore year rolled around, I decided to go back to school because I had finally made the varsity show choir team. This was a goal that I had been focused on since seventh grade. I know, pretty obsessive, at least in my mind. But when I had gone back to school, nothing was the same. I was physically isolated from my friends and had to wear a mask everywhere I went. But what really made me upset was having to sing with a mask on. I'm not trying to make this about masks or no masks, but God opened my eyes personally to see that this group wasn't worth the effort. My voice is more valuable in a fearless setting where I can openly sing and share the truth. So I decided to do school online and drop out of show choir and choir altogether. I told my friends, and many didn't believe me because they had only known me from my obsession with getting into this group. But that day was the last day I talked to most of those so-called friends. Leaving school was like leaving my identity behind. I really didn't do much. I really wasn't much. But it was in the lonely times at home that I rediscovered my identity in Christ. I started listening to preachers with my mom at lunch. I started joining her outside in the mornings to read my Bible. I would stay up for hours into the night working ahead on schoolwork so I can enjoy my mornings reading the Bible with her. Watching her become more joyful and fearless made me realize I was missing something. I hadn't been depending on God. He orchestrated my lonely nights and my wholesome mornings to show me that I needed Him. Through my mom, God had brought me back to life. Into junior year, I thought it was fine with no friends because I had my very best friends, my mom and Jesus. But the Lord quickly shut those thoughts down and gave me a wonderful boyfriend and an opportunity to come to CHS. God opened my eyes to what healthy relationships and godly friendships look like. I was finally in a healthy environment for me to grow in dependence on God. At last, senior year arrives. Through both time and great mentors, God has shown me not only how to learn about Him, but how to live with Him. He has given me a hunger for truth and has shown me that no matter what comes next, He is always with me. So when someone asks what God has done in my life over the past 4 years, you can say He has rescued me from a trap of deceitful thoughts into life that is healthy, joyful, and abundant in His grace. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. Last year, when I was a junior, I stood up on this stage with two of my classmates, and I warned our class about the dangers of potentially being lazy throughout our senior year. And going into my senior year, I personally was very scared that I wouldn't be working hard enough with senioritis setting in and other things that were going on in my life at the time. And then on our first day of AP Physics, Ms. Cleveland told us that we needed to select a class first and that we were all to submit one. And then a week later, we came to decide on Isaac's verse, which is the one that I have selected to share with you guys today. It's Proverbs 22:13, and it reads, "The sluggard says, 'There's a lion outside. I'll be killed in the public square.'" Now, for a lot of people, this verse sounds a bit weird since it's not a lot like other proverbs where they're feel good or they're, you know, really important to know. But it is. And by the way, to the physics class, I love you guys, even you, Susan. And the reason it means so much to me is that it's just like an encouragement to never let anything even if there's like the verse says, a lion outside, to let anything discourage you from working hard and forwarding the characteristics that God tells us to. Throughout this year, many challenges have afflicted me personally, and I'm sure everyone here. And this is going to continue far beyond the walls of just this school. Whatever happens, I hope that you take this verse with you, and you remember that whatever challenges may come, it's never a reason to stop living for Christ. Woo!
This year has been a year of just reflection for me, and I think looking back, just what I've realized is how God has been so evident in my life, and I've just overlooked all the little things He's given me. If I was to give one piece of advice, it would definitely be just to talk to God. I mean, He's right there waiting for you.
Be patient and just keep pursuing Him.
He is faithful and He will come through for you.
When I was brought to my lowest, all I had left to turn to was Him. Then that relationship began to flourish.
Use this resource of God being constantly poured into your life. Definitely don't take it for granted.
It feels like things aren't happening the way that you want. First of all, it's true. You know, what you want isn't always what He wants, and what He wants is perfect and so much better. So just sit back, relax. He's got you. You don't have to worry so much.
Because God is my friend, I don't have to worry about my future.
Because God is my Father, I can go to Him whenever I need to.
Because God is my refuge and strength, I can depend on Him and let Him lead me.
Because God is sovereign, I don't have to feel like I have to be.
Because God is comforting, I can be at peace.
Because God loves others, I'm called to love others.
Hi, my name is Cody Hee, and I'll be sharing my testimony today. I was raised in the church in a Christian household. My father and my grandparents constantly poured Christ into me. I even went to a private elementary school called FBCA. And there they offered a summer camp through a community called Center Kids. So the summer after fourth grade, I decided I would go on this trip, and it was a week-long trip at some random college in the middle of nowhere. But it was this one Wednesday night of that week, after the service, they offered a time to come down, come forward and accept Christ. And I did. I went down and met with a counselor. His name was Jonathan. He had this really long brown wavy hair. I don't know why I remember that. I just do. And he walked me through what I was doing, the steps, and made sure that I was ready to take Christ as my Savior. And that night I did. But it took me a longer time to recognize Him as my Lord. He had to break me to get my attention. So in eighth grade, I started to struggle with sin. Nothing really happened in my life until quarantine, and that is when it truly took a hold of my life. I started to consume my time, my thoughts. I started to isolate myself from my friends and my family even more than I already was. It was in this time I felt so alone, so trapped, and so ashamed. I hated myself at every time I felt of this temptation. I even convinced myself that God couldn't love somebody like me. The enemy had convinced me that I was so alone that I couldn't talk to anybody about my struggle because I was the only one going through it. I mean, this mindset did not change my life until last year. Dame Bishop, who graduated, who was a senior from last year, stood up at chapel and had a little sermon. Afterwards, I went and talked to him about it. We eventually got a group of guys to meet every week and start fighting this problem. And I thought that this would fix it, but it didn't. I tried everything in my own willpower to fight it. Nothing worked. I remember one night, I just broke down. I got on my knees and cried out to God, "Save me, please." I was just so tired of trying to fight this on my own, and I couldn't do it. And then in that moment, He brought to mind something that Mr. Brownfield had talked to us about, spiritual displacement. It's not enough just to get rid of the bad that's inside of us, but we must fill it with good. And so I did. I started to get into the Word. I started to pray more. And this prayer wasn't just saying the words. I tried that. It doesn't work. you have to mean it. And I truly did this time. I can feel this burden being lifted off of my shoulders every time. I continue to get into the Word daily. But this didn't happen overnight, but over a span of a couple months. But through His Word and by the power of Jesus, I found freedom, and a freedom in Christ. And it's because of Him that last month I've been a year free from this sin that had a grip on my life. And I don't say that to pat myself on the shoulder, but to show the power of God and what He can do for you. And I just want to say, for anyone struggling with anything, first of all, you aren't alone in it. And second, freedom is possible. You aren't trapped like the enemy wants you to think you are. For 2 years, I thought I could find satisfaction in sin and in this world. But the truth is, there is no complete satisfaction outside of Jesus Christ. And that realization is the first step to the path of freedom. Thank you. Woo!
Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light.
I have said these things to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation. But take heart, I have overcome the world. I want you to know that tough times will come, and you have been given a foundation here at Christian High School. And know that there is some fleeting happiness that will come your way in our world, but true joy is only attainable through Jesus Christ.
Remember who you are and whose you are. You are a child of the one true God, created in His image to reflect Him in your words, actions, and thoughts. You have been set apart to do great things. Remember to see the world through the eyes of Jesus and to consider how your choices will impact the kingdom of God.
So you may notice in life that the people that you start a journey with may not be the ones that you end it with, and that's okay. What's important is that as you grow in different directions, that you end those relationships well. Don't burn bridges. And enjoy the different people that God is going to bring into your life over the next season.
Some of you are going to find yourself in trouble. I know I did. When you find yourself in trouble, don't be afraid to go home. Those people, the mom, the dad, the mimi, the papa, whoever they are, those are the ones who've been praying for you your whole life.
You want clarity of where you're supposed to go and to move forward and big decisions in your life, highly, highly recommend and plead with you and beg you to have God's Word in your heart at all times. Memorize it, quote it. His Word brings light.
In Hebrews, it tells us to spur one another on to love and good works. So you need to find people who can do that for you, and you can do it for them.
Pick a church, pick a Bible-believing church. Now that you're kind of an adult, you can go maybe where you want to go and do something to dig in.
And I want to share a verse with you that Jesus shared with His disciples in John chapter 16, verse 33. He told His disciples, "I have said these things to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation. But take heart, I have overcome the world." Thank you, class of 2023. May God bless you, and I love you.
Hi, everyone. I'm Emma Chase Peterson, and I'm gonna give a part of my testimony. So this isn't my whole testimony or a list of highs and lows of my faith. This is just me and my love for God. So to start, I have been blessed by going to a private Christian school my entire life. When you think of someone going to a Christian school, you automatically think it's because their whole family is Christian. Well, for me, that isn't the case, because most of my family doesn't know God. I didn't go to church on Sunday, and I couldn't ask most of my family about God. I'm not telling you all this because I'm angry or want you to have pity on me. I am sharing this to say that your family and your family life don't define your identity in Christ. I was put into a Christian school for a reason, and God is using me as a light to my family. I know God is real because I have felt the love of God in the walls of these schools. In every classroom, I feel God in every chapel on Wednesday, and in every bag class for the last 4 years. In the school, I truly found my identity in Christ. I found a passion for God and the desire to show his love to my family and friends. I was taught that Jesus came and died and rose again, that my sins are forgiven, and that my family's sins are not my own. I learned to worship with my hands in the air and to not be ashamed like I was before. And a time I wholeheartedly felt God was this past spiritual emphasis week. The morning I was driving to school and I couldn't get a worship song out of my head. I couldn't remember the name of the song or most of the lyrics, and so I asked God to play the song in chapel. And I know that might sound like a silly prayer or some waste of time, and by the time I got in my chapel seat, I had already forgotten about the little moment we had until worship started. I had already felt the power of God during the first two songs, and then I heard the third song. It was the song I had prayed for. I immediately started to cry, and I felt the presence of God. I got a wave of courage, and I know God supplied it to me. I went to the bottom of the stage and got on my knees to praise the Lord. I wasn't sad or scared. I was just so overcome with the love of God. So with all that being said, don't take these opportunities for granted. Pray about the littlest things and the big ones too. Appreciate your teachers and tell your Bible teachers you love them, because teaching the Word of God is not easy. Don't complain about your Bible class, because for some people, that's the only time they get to learn about God. For some people, that's the only time they get prayed for, and it's just a safe place for some people. Thank you.
Hello, guys. My name is Lincoln. I will be reading to you today 2 Corinthians 5, verse 7. It says, "For we walk by faith, but not by sight." I know it's a short verse, but I feel like there's a lot of power this verse holds. Often we lose sight of what God wants us to do. I know for me, I want to try to control things, and it never works out. And that's how I ended up at the school. I didn't want to come here at first, but it's probably the best thing that's ever happened to me. For everyone, please remember this verse and put your faith in God, because he has a plan for you, and it's a special plan designed just for you and no one else. Thank you.
Dropping you off at 14.
there's just so much you can't do, and you can't wait to move out someday and call your own shots. But don't make her drop you off around the block. Remember that she's getting older too, and don't lose the way that you dance around in your PJs getting ready for school. Yeah.